And tonight, we've got the best in the business. I always say it on Friday nights. Assembled here, people that have been involved in these games. Duke with the Western Bulldogs, of course, the Chief many times with the Hawks. Juddy with, of course, the West Coast Eagles in that famous era in the mid-2000s. Damien Barrett's here as well. So your big team's assembled on a Friday night. Juddy, nice to see you. And now a permanent fixture on Friday night.
JB, good to be here. The best weekend of football of the year. So very excited to see this game tonight.
Oh, it's and could not be set up better. The weather is perfect. Damo, hello to you.
Hello, Jim. This is the seasoned, hardened sides, isn't it, on the preliminary final fixturing this weekend. We've got the other one tomorrow night, which has got most of the general public's fascination. But this is the teams that have been there and done it before. And I still can't pick it, Jim.
You've been... How many prelims, Chief? You won four premierships, so that's at least four. But what was the tally?
No, it's not. No, because... Back in the old days, you didn't have to go through prelims if you won the qualifying final. You'd go straight into the grand final.
So you skipped most of
the top five. Yes, I didn't play many prelims at all.
Good. Just had the week off and watched everyone punch on.
Ideally, yes. That's the way you want to do it. We had to go through it the hard way once or twice. But I just love the fact we've got two of the genuine heavyweights of the last decade that are going to go at it tonight. And only one's going to get through. It'll be a last man standing affair.
And Duke, seven prelims for the Dogs in the modern era. How many of them did you play?
A couple of them, 97 and 98. That's since 1985. Yes. And a club that's only been in two grand finals. So 2 hours away from a third grand final and an enormous amount of excitement about the opportunity that may bring.
Just watching our Triple M Chemist Warehouse replay screen, I love this, Duke, because they had the vision of the prelim final between the Swans and the Cats at the SCG, I think it was. I'm not sure what year that
was. Can't quite remember the year.
I think it was back to... I'm not sure what was the final, Jim, or what it was. I reckon it was back to 97 or 8, because Shannon Grant was playing for the Swans in the game you're referring to.
Well, one of the reasons I love it is because this man was a very fine footballer, so don't get me wrong, but there were quite often games where Geelong had 17 players playing out there because Bill Brownless was unsighted. And I just watched every single highlight of that. Did not get within 15 metres of the ball, Duke.
Wasn't seen a lot there, Bill, I have to admit.
Not once did he touch it in the whole bit of vision we saw.
Creating a lot of space for Gaz, Jim.
This is a bloke who, by the way, kicked 9 in a final and 8 in a final and kicked a lot of goals in finals. So we not putting too much SH1T on him, the big bustling Billy Brownless. But he did have games, Duke, where, seriously, he was a statue. He was a witch's hat.
The gap between his best and his worst, Bill, was probably some length. And just on our Chemist Warehouse replay, it's going the freeze screen.
Don't go there.
The most goals in a five. Chief quickly leant over and pointed to.
Did you see me there?
Duke, put your hand on your heart and say that I leant over and pointed out.
Wanted it pointed out.
Your presence was guiding us.
Swearing on the life of your kids.
Desperate for it to be brought up.
You don't need to point for us to know that you... And look at him. Look at me.
Like everyone's aware.
Gordon, hang on a minute. You just told a blatant lie that I pointed to something that was on the TV. Now you're trying to pop me for sitting back. You can't have it both ways, Jim.
He loves
just
it,
a nice level of comfort. That's it.
Unbelievable.
Gordon, commentary had you covered, Chief, in finals goals.
He's got everyone covered by a margin too.
That 87 grand final really cost you, didn't it?
It did, Chief. It did. Imagine if you played in that and kicked a nice bag of six.
Yeah. What do you mean if? Oh! Come on, Jim.
This is why he's a September master.
He is, isn't he?
Just up he comes and gets a nice little sort of whiff about him, the Chief. Just saw, Duke, is what your female silverback in the mist. When the Chief gets a real sense, forward he comes, and she's just got to submit.
It was a...
There can be no arguing with the big boy.